In this lesson, we are going to look at what are conjugate acid-base pairs. Now, it is based on the definition of the Bronsted-Lowry acid and base. Based on Bronsted-Lowry, an acid is a proton donor. And what is a proton donor? A proton is basically a hydrogen with a positive charge. Now, if an acid is a donor, something must be accepting that proton, because acid and base are the opposite of each other. So in this case, a base, it would be the proton acceptor. In order to accept this positive charge, this base must have a negative charge or a lone pair. So keep that in mind, proton is hydrogen with a positive charge, and a base is a proton acceptor, so it must have a negative charge. So let's look at an example. In this case, we have this chemical reaction. And how do we identify the pair? Notice the term pairs. That is, they look very similar to each other. Notice we have HCO3-, and over here we have H2CO3. They look very similar. This does not look like Cl, so we know this is a pair to some extent. In this case, this one has that negative right there. And this one has an extra hydrogen right there. You notice right away that this has accept a hydrogen. So in this case, this has a minus right there, and this minus has accept a hydrogen. So this has to be a base. Going back to ideas, that base is a proton acceptor. So this is gonna accept a proton, and once it accepts a proton, it's gonna become an acid, which has an extra hydrogen right there. So we call this conjugate acid right there. If this is one pair, the rest must be another pair. In this case, we know that hydrochloric acid is an acid, but let's say we don't know that. Let's say we don't know HCl is an acid. We have HCl and Cl-. Notice that negative right there. That tells you this has to be a base. And since this base is on the product side, it must be a conjugate, because all the conjugate are on the product side. And this has to be acid that's producing that conjugate base. Let's try another problem. We have HCO3- again, and what does that look like? It doesn't look like water, of course. Of course it looked like, and it looked like CO3- too. So if we notice again, we have a negative, but we also have a negative here. What's the difference? Now this negative is 2 negative. That means it has more light versus a negative one. In this case, CO3 has 2-, and this one has 1-. What makes this a base versus this one an acid? That is because this one does not have a hydrogen. And we can see that it has lost a hydrogen somewhere in the process. So HCO3-, in this case, even though it has a negative, it can be functioned as an acid. So this is now an acid. So this is gonna be its conjugate base. Which makes sense. The acid lose the proton and become this. Now, with the 2-, of course, it can accept 2 proton too. If this is one pair, the rest must be the other pair. So here we have OH-, which we know is a base already, and we have water, so they look very similar. In this case, we have that minus right there. That tells you it has to be a base. And comparing to water, the water has no charge at all. This must be its acid right there, or conjugate acid. In addition to identifying the acid-base pair, we had to realize their relative strength. That is, what happened when a strong acid becomes a conjugate base. So we're going to talk about the relative strength of the acid pair in this case. That is, they have an opposite relationship. A strong acid would have a very weak conjugate base. For instance, if I have hydrochloric acid right there, extremely corrosive and very strong, it would disassociate completely in water, and therefore this would be a very weak one. So this would be weak compared to this to be very strong. Since the strong acid have a weak conjugate base, what happens when we have a strong conjugate base? Of course we have a weak acid, so it's vice versa. For the base, it's the same thing. When you have a strong base, you have a weak conjugate acid, and vice versa. If we have a strong conjugate acid, I would have a weak base.